Many of you may know that January 11th this year, 2020, is National Thank You Day. Now, I'm not big on days and months and all that stuff, but that's the world we live in. So, you know, sometimes you got to mention them. I am a big proponent of gratitude in all aspects of life. That's something that I've really worked on and not celebrated, that's not the word, practiced for many, many years. And especially in this last 4 years during the battle that I've had with cancer. But I think gratitude is important, even if you don't have cancer, no matter who you are, what stage of life, what income level you have, it doesn't matter. Gratitude is something that cuts across all of that and connects you to another human being because of your appreciation for them or for what they've done for you. So I'm going to take this opportunity to say thank you to a few people that have been on my list that I wanted to follow up with, because as many of you know, I had a double mastectomy early in December. In December for us, we had many days where we were struggling. I was, of course, down, and my husband was struggling with getting it all done. So at one point, I finally reached out to my church and said, we really need support with meals. It wasn't about money. It was the fact that my husband was having a hard time doing it all, which, as many of you know, anytime one partner is down or ill, even just with a cold or flu, much less surgery or something major, it has an impact on the way the household runs. So many people stepped up and shared with us and brought us food and sent us gift cards. And I just want to call out their names as a way to say thank you, because it meant so much to us. Pat and Randy obviously brought us some yummy soup. Mary Gibbons was kind enough to send us a Grubhub, which we're big Grubhub, DoorDash people, send us a gift certificate. We got something from US Pizza from Prissy and Susan, who are part of PP Gemfish, Patch's Bible study women's group. And also from that same group, Judy sent us something from Chick-fil-A. Thank you, Judy. Also from our church, Eli and Jan gave us something from Grubhub. Thanks, guys. And the dinners themselves that came, which were lovely and so varied and fabulous. We were very thankful to receive things from Harry and Melanie, Deb, Shelby and Matthew, Paul and Tracy, Jennifer on Christmas Day of all things, which is still blows my mind. Thank you, Jennifer. Amazing, amazing lunch. Emily, Linda, Georgia Morris, and even a Whole Foods gift certificate from Miguel and Kelsey. So thank you, thank you, thank you to all of you. We so appreciated it. And I think this is just a good example of how sometimes you need to actually speak aloud to others your thankfulness, because it gives a good example and it just connects you to let people know that you have a grateful heart. So I would challenge you today, as we're now just past January 11th and the rest of the month is National Thank You Month, who do you need to go back to and say thank you for? Maybe it's not something big, maybe it's very little, maybe it's the fact that the guy at the coffee shop smiles at you every day and you've never appreciated that. I don't know. Why don't you think about it? And share below in the comments, if you're led, who else can you thank today that will bring a smile to their heart? And it brings a smile to yours as well to do it. Hope you have a good day. Be thankful. Every day is a gift.